Good morning, everybody. So today we are going to present you our data mining project. Me, Atin Sara, and C. Absetu, and the third member were not able to be here today, Swazik. So today we are going to present you our MAB flight digital analysis. First, we know that in the airlines domain, the daily flights cause a loss of time and money regarding to the customer client. It is one of the toughest difficulties in the aviation control. So today we are going to present your analysis based on the data set of the Malaysia Airlines. First, we are going to present you the problem statement and the objective of this analysis. Then we are going to present you the developed solution, our experiments, observation, and then conclude for how the delay are caused and if we can expect them. So our problem statement is how can we establish an effective model to handle the delay prediction problem. So this is our main problem statement, and this is the main question that we keep in mind during all this project. And the objective is really to find the most ideal model which can allow us to predict the delay time and also the causes of this delay, which can be very efficient for the company to prevent him from lost this money and to improve their relationship with the customer. So we are going to use data mining to find out the answer of our question, and through three main steps. First, the data processing, which include all the preparation of the data, and then we are going to find out three predictive models that we will apply to this data set. And the first part is to evaluate the performance. So we took the three predictive model, evaluate the performance, and find out which of the predictive model is the best model to use to find the best solution.
So in the data processing part, we did first the data keying because we had 273 columns, which is a lot for a data set. And so for that, we had to select which one were the best. So we deleted all the empty columns and kept the one that were containing data. And then we found out that some of them were not useful for us. So we kept actually 15, and then we created four new variables for inside our data set. So here you cannot really see, but the four new variables are the delay codes. So we gathered all the delay codes. There were actually four delay codes. So we gathered it in one column. Then we had the total delay, because we noticed that the delay that were given to us were actually the delay only on the departure and not on the whole flight. We created also a delay category where you can see whether it's considered as no delay, small delay, medium, big, or very big delay. And also we created one that was the duration of flight, because we were not finding one inside our data set. So here are the predictive models that we built. So our main point was to find out the causes of the delays and also to find out the total delay. So for that, we created a decision tree model to find out the cause of all the delays. So here we can see how the model looks like. We also did deep learning to know about the delay category, like we just mentioned before, whether or not it's a small or a very big delay, because for a company, it doesn't waste the same amount of money. Then finally, we did a linear regression to find out to find out the total delay that we could have during a flight. So here are the three of them, and after that we measured to get the performance. Actually, we used our studio to do the linear regression, but we were not able to find the best performance. So we used RapidMiner to get a better one, and you can see the result up there with the root mean squared error. Then we did, like we said, deep learning for delay category, sorry. So the deep learning was using for the delay category, and actually it gave us a very high performance with 92%. And finally, with our decision tree, we get 98% of accuracy. So here, with all the results we found, we trained a lot of models actually, and these were the three last ones that we used that were accurate and efficient enough to respond to our main question, that was to be able to predict the total delay and also to predict the cause of all the delays. So thank you.
Of course, here the presentation is really a global presentation. So if you want to see more details, you can go check on the website, which will show you all the very deep details of the analysis. So thank you very much and have a good day.